see how to find out connected components in directed graph. So it is not so easy like finding connected components in undirected graph. Okay, so the time complexity was order of V plus E in undirected graphs. Here also order of V plus E, but it is little bit difficult to understand. So that is this algorithm. So this algorithm is proposed by Kosaraju. So that's why this algorithm is famously known as Kosaraju's algorithm. We are going to execute this Kosaraju's algorithm and we are going to find out connected components in a directed graph. Before that, what is connected component? We'll see first. Example, whenever I say two vertices belongs to same connected component in directed graph, the necessary condition and sufficient condition is A to P there should be a path and B to A there should be a path. That's it. Then we say A and B belongs to same connected component. That is the story. Now here you tell me, is there any two vertices so that you know they are reachable from each other? So 1 to 2 there is a path, but 2 to 1 there is no path. Similarly, what about 1 and 3? 1 to 3 we can reach, from 3 to 1 we cannot reach. So that's why I can say that if you cannot reach 3 from 1, maybe you can't reach 4 also, correct? Yes, we can't reach 5. But from 3, if you see, so 3 to 4 I can reach, correct? No. 3 to 5? No. Then 5 to 4? No. 4 to 5? No, right? So here everything is one connected component in this graph. No two vertices are reachable from each other, correct? So one is a separate connected component, two is a connected component, 3, 4, 5 all are connected components, right? We'll take one more example. One, let's say 2, 2 to 3, let's say 3 to 1. In this graph, let's add one more vertex, a few more vertices, 4 to 5, 5 to 6, let's say 4 to 6. In this graph, 1 to 2 there is a path, 2 to 1 also there is a path, correct? So 1, 2 belongs to same connected component. 2 to 3 we can reach and 3 to 2 we can reach, that's why. So 1, 2, 3 belongs to same connected component, because from anything to anything we can reach. That is what important. In this one, 4 to 5, 5 to 6 we can reach, 4 to 5, but we cannot reach 5 to 4. That's why 4 should be different, 5 should be different for sure. What about 6? 4 to 6 I can reach, but from 6 to 4 I cannot reach. Similarly, 5 to 6 I can reach, but 6 to 5 I cannot reach. That's why this is another component. Here, there are 1, 2, 3, 4 connected components. So this is about directed graph and connected components. So now this following algorithm is going to compute connected components in directed graph. How it works, we will see. Before that, please stop this video and read this algorithm. Okay. Now we'll read the algorithm. Call DFS of G to compute finishing times F of U for each vertex. We have to call DFS on a graph. Yes, we know that, right? And we know how to find out the finishing times, not a problem. After that, compute G transpose. Yes, already I taught you how to find out G transpose. After that, you call DFS again, but this time on G transpose. But in the main loop, in the first loop, I mean in first main program of DFS, consider the vertices in order of decreasing F of U. That means we call DFS generally in a random order, right? First of all, on any vertex. After that, when we come back to DFS main method, then next time which vertex we use select? Anything, correct? But in this problem, what we have to do is, first time you randomly do DFS. Second time, you have to do DFS on G transpose, but the vertices selection, I will tell you in the algorithm, don't worry. But the vertex selection will be based on decreasing F of U. Okay, so let's blindly run this algorithm and see what happens. The first step in this algorithm is calling DFS of G. So let's show DFS of G. So let's say DFS visit. So you tell me first what vertex will be visited. If I take random order, I'm assuming that let's say this is the order first I follow. One, let me maintain the linked list of vertices. Then from this I pick the vertices to initiate the DFS. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Let's say these are the following vertices. Okay, take one. Call DFS V of 1. We know the idea next. So, and you need linked list, correct? So what we do is, we assume that linked list is 1's neighbors are only 2. 2's neighbors are 3. 3's neighbors 1. 4's neighbor 5 and 6. And 5's neighbors 6, 6 neighbors, nothing, correct? This one, nothing. This is the adjacency list. Let's take this and do DFS. First, if I started DFS V of 1, what happened? Second step, DFS visit of 2 will be done. On that, DFS visit of 3 will be called. After that we'll go back, you know the story. So let's quickly do that. After that what happens, we will come back to main loop, and in main loop already 1 is visited, 2 is visited, 3 is visited, right? Then we'll come here 4. So on 4 we call it again. When I call DFS visit on 4, then we'll come to DFS visit of 5. So in this DFS of visit of 5, what happens, DFS visit of 6 will be done. This is the execution sequence. Now what this algorithm does is, it also computes f of u. We know that whenever you call DFS, so we know how to find out the finishing times. You tell me, what are the finishing times and starting times of every function call? In a function call, did you remember, in DFS visit, if you see the method, you understand there is a noting of d of u and finishing of u, correct? DFS d of u, on that I wrote f of u and d of u. So we know how to update d of u and f of u based on time variable. Please go through that method, then only you can understand this algorithm. So whenever first time when you come to DFS visit, we maintain the time. So 1 first, time begins with 1. After that we will go here, then in this one starting time, so these are all starting time will become 2. After that we'll come here, then starting while become 3, because time will be incremented every time. So then after that this method will be closed. While closing the method, we update the finishing time. Finishing time is 1 more than the previous time, so 4. Next, DFS visit will be, of 2 will be finished, then it will become 5. Then we are going to close DFS visit of 1, at that time finishing time will be updated, so it is 6. So starting times are 1, 2, 3, finishing times are 4, 5, 6. So please go through that algorithm. Next, DFS, now code comes here, then starting time will be 7 and then 8. Correct? Then if you see, on 4 we called 5, on 5 we called 6, after that we went back, perfect. So after that 9, correct? On 9 it will be closed, then will become 10, then 11 here, 12 here. These are the starting times and finishing times of every function call. Now what is the next step? Compute G transpose. Let me do G transpose now. So what is G transpose of this graph? Did you remember? G transpose is nothing but, whenever they have edge 1 to 2, we have to make 2 to 1. Let's do it. Then your graph would become like this. 2 to 1, correct? Then 2 to 3 will become 3 to 2, right? Here let me write like this. 1, 2, but edge will be reversed like this. 1 to 2 will become 2 to 1. 2 to 3 will become 3 to 2. Then 3 to 1 will become 1 to 3. Next, 4 to 5 will become 5 to 4. 4 to 6 will become 6 to 4. And 5 to 6 will become 6 to 5. This is G transpose. So for this G transpose matrix, I mean graph, we are going to find out what? Again DFS. But this time, the vertex selection, like how to call DFS, we have to go, you have to go through this finishing times. Based on the finishing times, we have to go. But sir, how to know that whose finishing time is highest, whose finishing time is first and all? Simple. So when you are executing DFS calls, so this was first finish it, right? So you add a code such a way that in the DFS method, simple line, whenever you are closing that DFS at any time, simply append that node. Example, here 3 is going to be closed, right? Whenever you close any method, add this to this empty linked list. You have a linked list here, okay? This is, let's say, linked list. Here I am going to maintain a linked list which is initially empty. Whenever a function is closed, any of them, that corresponding value will be there, no, vertex, that vertex number will be appended in the linked list. And always I do insert in front. Example, you see, first code starts here, comes here. First time DFS visit of 3 will be closed, right? Whenever you are closing it, with one extra instruction, we can create a node for in a linked list. That means you can insert in front of linked list. So what is that node? 3, right? Add 3. Next, this will be closed. Add 2 in that way. So 2, after that 3. Then we'll come here. At that time, on behalf of 1, add 1. It takes, after all, constant time, right? Inserting in front of the list. Now, after that, code comes here, code comes here, code comes here. Then 6 will be, DFS visit of 6 will be closed. When this is closed, add 6 here, then it would become 6, 1, 2, 3. After that, 8 will be, 5 will be closed, then add here. After that, 4 will be closed, then add it. In that way, 4, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3 will be the order. Understand? So now we have to do the third step. In the third step, we have to call depth first search of G transpose. So let's do. But the order of the picking the vertices is 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3. That's it. If you remember that, that's fine. So DFS we have to call first on 4. If you call on 4, what is the adjacency list? Let's write adjacency list. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1's neighbors are, 1 has any neighbor? 3. 2 has 1. 3 has here in this problem 2. 4 has anything? Nothing. So 5 has 1 neighbor 4. 6 has 4 and 5. Okay, remember it. So when DFS of 4 is called, on that neighbors of 4 is nothing, then immediately it will be closed. That's why in the output, so now this say that this is one component, 4 is one component. Okay, now continue the process. What is the second depth first search? So we have to call depth first search again from 5 this time. When you call from 5, what happens? 5 has a neighbor 4, but 4 is already visited, right? Then we don't call it back, we know that. Then 5 has any other neighbor? Nothing. So this will be closed. Then in the output, you print 5. So 4 is one component, 5 is another component. Now again continue the process. This time DFS visit will be called from where? 6. So now traverse 6. 6 neighbors are 4 and 5, but 4 and 5 already got called. That's why no new neighbor. Stop it. Then 6 will be outputted. This is the third component. In that way you separate the components. Now after that we take 1 and we call depth first search of 1. So when you call on 1, what happens if you see this one? So in this graph 1, 2, 3, there is a neighbor, correct? Here also you can see 1, 2, 3. So DFS visit of 1 will call DFS visit of 3. DFS of visit of 3 will call what? DFS visit of 2. Now 1, 2, 3 are visited, correct? Now after that, no new neighbors. It will be closed, it will be closed, it will be closed. We know how DFS works, correct? Now once it is closed, now this entire thing is one unit of DFS calls, correct? That's why I treat this entire thing as a component. So 1, 2, 3 will be printed in the next phase. So 4 is printed in one phase, 5 is another phase, 6 is another third phase. In the fourth phase, 1, 2, 3 all together will be printed. So this is nothing but finding the connected components. This is Kose Raju's algorithm's execution. Okay. If you see the time complexity, what we did? We did after all two times depth first search, right? So one is on G, second is on G transpose. Number of edges in G and G transpose are same. That's why time complexity will be V plus E first time, second time V plus E. So all together V plus E. So time complexity of finding connected components in directed graphs with best algorithm is order of V plus E. Okay. There are some algorithms which process your graph only one time. Here you processed graph two times. Of course, one time graph, second time G transpose, right? It is like, you know, two times order of V plus E, right? 2 into V plus E. But there are some efficient algorithms because of torsion. But you know, that is already, you know, this is not a gate standard thing. It is more than gate standard. So that's why Kose Raju algorithm even is more than gate standard, right? To understand. So there is an algorithm called torsion algorithm, which is proposed by torsion, that takes order of V plus E, however, but that visits all the vertices of the graph and all the edges of the graph only one time. This Kose Raju algorithm is visiting graph two times, one time G, second time G transpose. Understand? That's why that Tarjan's algorithm is little bit better than this Kose Raju, but asymptotically not great. Okay.